Ladies and gentlemen, the blue corner, Margarite Butcher!
And here comes the first challenger for the Australian female middleweight title, Margarite Iron Doll Butcher. Only two fights in the pro fight. Both of those were to Harris. She's 32 years of age. She's from Fight World Australia up in the Gold Coast. She came in last night at 72.25 kg. No actually amateur boxing fights. Muay Thai is her game. She's had 16 fights, 10 wins, 7 wins, KO. She's had 6 Muay Thai fights this year. She's just spent the last 9 months over in Thailand on training camp. So pro debut was against Tayla. Tayla was 6-0-1 back in the Tayla 2. It was a unanimous decision. Both girls know each other very well here. This would be, you'd imagine, a close affair. Hits, the crowd sits in anticipation, and the arrival of the phenomenon. She's nothing less than an absolute phenomenon at the moment, Tayla Harris. What a popular young girl this is, 22 years of age. She's got to be one of the most popular sports stars in Australia at the moment. Main trainer's Farris Chevalier, former Australian super middleweight champion, very, very talented. Farris, he went 11-1 in the pros. She's from Queensland, Australia. She tipped the scales last night, 72.5 kilograms. At the moment, she's ranked number 7 in the WBA in the middleweight division.
Ladies and gentlemen, the bell goes for first, for the first procedural 8-round contest for the Australian middleweight title, judges ringside, Marlo Valley, Andrew Butler, Brent Mann, the man in charge, when the bell goes for the first procedural 8, Mr. Alan McCall. Ladies and gentlemen, fight fans, this is our co-feature main event, 8 rounds of boxing for the Australian middleweight title, and proudly presented by Road Trim Civil. This one is for you. And now, pound for pound, round by round, fight fans, here we go! First up, and presenting to you on my left, with a professional CV that reads his way, 2 fights with 2 losses, a Muay Thai fighter with 16 fights, with 6 consecutive wins of her last 7 fights, with Nick Atkins, the corner, from the Gold Coast, Queensland, Australia. Tonight she dances a 3rd time, sporting black with white piping, presenting Margarite Butcher! And so we go, and into the red corner we travel, with a professional paper punch CV that reads this way, 6 professional fights, 5 wins and a draw, and tipping the scales at 72.5 kilograms, with former Australian super middleweight champion. In the corner, Farris Chevalier, Nigel Stark for Team Ellis Gymnasium, originally from Queensland, women's AFL superstar, the Carlton girl, the multi-talented Fraser Trickson, Tayla Harris, and Brian's presenting.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome you to the next round of the day.
Well, here we go, guys. Round one of a very, very anticipated matchup. This is the third. And Barry Michael, what are we expecting?
Well, you know, like, I mean, Tayla Harris, a very athletic girl, and, you know, she's already had two victories over Margarite Butcher. And, you know, I mean, I think the majority of Australia expects her to have the third victory for the vacant Australian title. Saying that Butcher's, you know, an experienced kickboxer, you know, she might make an interesting fight, but Tayla, and she's had some good knockouts in Muay Thai fighting as well. But Tayla Harris is an athlete. She's got a real good jab, she's got a long reach, and she's improving every fight.
Yeah, certainly right. She's got a very, very long, she's 6 foot, must be 6'1". She's got a great little jab on her, and as you said, but I'm looking, what I'm really looking for, I want to see an improvement. She had a big, big draw here. The last time I seen her was actually on the 17th of November last year when I watched her fight Sarah Dwyer. And that was a big, big fight, Gary. And it told a lot of stories that night.
Oh, wow. She's got Margarite Butcher in some trouble already. Sorry, Steve. You're going.
Nah, this is exactly what I wanted. This is the point I was going to make. Anyways, this is what I wanted to see her. Use her distance. Use our long straight punches, create the distance, and don't get sucked into anything like she did against Dwyer. That was a big, big fight.
Oh, big right hand. Tayla Harris's right hand working beautifully. She's got Margarite Butcher in a fair bit of trouble in this opening round, I think.
Stevie, Barry, lovely to join you on the telecast, epicenter.tv, wherever you are, joining us around the world. Tayla Harris, Barry, she is a bona fide superstar and very much Victorian royalty.
Yeah, undoubtedly, you know, quality league footballer and superb athlete she is. And she's improving every fight. I did a bit of pad work with her a couple of weeks ago and gave her a few pointers. I like that she's got a great jab, fast hands, and a good right hand. I'd just like to see her. Oh, big shot. Hit Margarite Butcher with a big right hand. Wow. Big round for Tayla Harris.
Yeah, that was a big, big round for Tayla Harris. And you know what? She made a big, big statement there tonight, Barry. She landed three lovely, beautiful right hands. And very, very telling punches, which will definitely sway the judges towards her. But it's been, she's a tough, tough girl, this Margarite Butcher. You know, as I said, Muay Thai background. 16 fights, 10 wins, 7 knockouts. There's power there, Mark.
Yeah, it means she can punch.
I didn't know her nickname was the Iron Doll. I do now. Stevie, you've certainly done your homework. I was busy over there reminiscing. I found a bell that Damien Membre is using that was utilised back in 1985. I've been stalking Barry Michael ever since. Wow, 12th of July, 1985. I'll tell you something else I learned tonight, gentlemen. That it may well have been the last 15 rounder of all time.
No, it was. I think it was the second last 15 rounder in.
Well, yeah, never let the truth get in the way of a good story,
that
Barry.
Went, the second last that went 15, I think, world title. But I like the sound of it.
Round two action. Mark Warren with Stevie and Barry Michael, the former IBF super featherweight champion. Who'll ever forget it? Who'll ever forget that day? Where were you when he did it with Lester Ellis, who's across the canvas from us tonight? So Tayla, big on the jab, tall on the reach, broad on the shoulders, and Barry's probably alluded to that already.
Yep.
Butcher, she's walk-up fighter, she's plenty tough, but she's open to one perhaps down the middle.
Well, you know, the right hands work extremely well, but oh, wow.
And anything can happen in boxing. Let's see how the third man saw it.
Listen, in fairness, Marguerite's landed three cracking right hands of her own in this fight. And just coming over the top of the Harris jab.
Oh,
that's a big, big shot. The referee's got to count that. That was right on the button.
Yes, wasn't it ever. That was a bomb.
Alan McCall having a close look. Round two action. Tayla smells blood in the water. Margarite, we said, plenty tough. She's a Muay Thai fighter. She's been in there and danced twice before.
Oh,
third dance, big right hand. They're going to stop this. They've got to stop this.
He's got to stop it.
It's
that's
over.
It.
Wow. Wow.
Big, 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 wow. Big win from Tayla.
What a statement.
My God almighty.
What a statement.
We talked about it, didn't we?
Wow.
How is it all going to go down?
What how about that?
Did the Dwyer fight cost her? My God, she came back with a bomb. And the legend is gone, Barry. The legend is gone.
Wow, that was amazing. That, she's gone to another level. And I've seen her in the gym. I've seen the improvement. And I'll tell you what, you know, once she look, she can go. She can go a long, long way, this girl. That was incredibly impressive. You know, especially against a girl that she's fought twice before and gone the distance with, and you know, has had Muay Thai experience as well. And that was extremely impressive from Tayla Harris.
You can see that she's improved over the last 2 years, considering there were decision victories and now those second round stoppage. It's going to put her in good stead. She's currently ranked the WBA number 7, and she's only going to rise from here.
For sure.
Champion is Clarissa Shields. Wouldn't that be something? Clarissa Shields coming here to Australia, or Tayla Harris going over to the United States and facing off against one another.
Unbelievable stuff. What a statement from Tayla Harris tonight. Man.
And you know what? It's what I was looking for. It's what I said at the start. We didn't get enough. We probably didn't get enough time to talk, say everything we wanted to say about it. But you know, these are the questions I wanted answered tonight. And my God, did she answer them?
She
fantastic.
She answered it in a big way. She really did. So you know, sorry, Jordan. What I've seen with Tayla, when she gets someone hurt, she goes for it. She's got a killer instinct. She likes to finish them off, and she's getting better at it every time.
Yeah, she's getting better at it. It's like she didn't rush it. You know,
it was pinpoint
accuracy. And like that first knockdown was just a beauty of a right
hand.
Wasn't
it? Yeah.
And then the second one, she just had her opponent reeling but kept her distance. Yep. Yeah. Great coaching from Laura Chevalier, because he's really done a great job here.
That was unreal.
Let's make this official. This lady is Victorian royalty. Margarite is in good hands. And so now, a professional record that reads 7 with 6 wins and 1 draw and 1 by way of KO at 118 of round number 2 and the new Australian middleweight champion. Well, and they said she couldn't punch. My goodness, you closed out the fight. You're a lovely girl with a smile on the dial, but you smelled blood in the water and you closed out the show tonight.
Yeah, I
wanted
to make a statement. I haven't got a complete knockout yet, so that was the aim of this fight, and the Paris might come out all the composure in the world, and here we are.
Tell me about being Tayla Harris in 2019. Tell me how you're mixing up your codes between AFL and the square ring, and perhaps how difficult is it to pursue the boxing here as a female with fighters to get them in here with you now?
It's not difficult when you're on the sport. I guess opposition, this is the kind of thing I have to do to draw attention, so hopefully from this we can get some more moving forward. And obviously, I've got footy season coming up, so I'll switch my mind around to that. Go Baggers. Yeah. And then next year we'll be back in the ring, but something else.
So it's fair to say you're part of the Carlton crew.
I am the boss of the Carlton crew.
Yeah. You're fantastic tonight. I'm sure you've got some people you'd like to thank. The new Australian middleweight champion.
Oh, I have everyone who comes and supports me at footy, at boxing, in general life. The only reason I box is to try and make them proud, and Shaggy, Dad, and Faris in my corner tonight, and then everyone that I work with along the way. That's how I can manage to love my job, because I have the perfect preparation.
You're starting to work with the boys and the girls at Team Ellis Gymnasium. And you've got some special stuff and programs working that we've been plugging throughout the night. What's your ultimate dream for boxing if you look down the road? Can you see yourself on the international stage?
Yeah, absolutely. It's obviously something you want to pursue. If you're a boxer, you want to go to the highest level. And I guess the next step is probably international, so we'll see what we can do there. But I just take guidance from my people, and then I basically just do it on top.
She's going to take advice from her people. And Sarah goes. Tayla Harris on epicenter.tv and the new Australian middleweight champion. Congratulations.
Go Baggers.
Go Baggers.
I just